Okay, rheumatoid arthritis, it is an autoimmune disease and it involves the systemic organs, okay? Mostly involving the joint, but it may also involve the blood vessels, heart, skin, lungs and muscle. And the main tissue being affected is the synovium without the production of pus. There is no pus formation, so it is a non-supputative, proliferative and inflammatory synovitis, and it later leads to the destruction of the cartilage and the ankylosis of joint. Okay, the pathogenesis involves the genetic susceptibility, environmental arthritogen and the autoimmunity. For the genetic susceptibility, you must have studied in that HLA or the MHC complex. Have you studied? Have you studied MHC complex?
MHC1, MHC2 wala hume.
Oh. This one the DP, DQDR or padhe the nahi na?
Yes, it's fine, ma'am. DQ wala.
MHC अनि ABC हरु MHC class 1 मा चाहिँ AB र C अनि class 2 मा चाहिँ DPDQDR जस्तो गरेर त्यसको उ डोमेनहरु पढेन
हैन मैम त्यो एक्टिभेसन अफ त्यो इम्युन सिस्टम वाला मा मात्र पढेको MHC 1 र MHC 2
ए ल तर त्यत्रो त्यो डिटेल मा अभी पढाएर अलि भ्याउँदैन है तर जनरली चाहिँ व्हाट यु शुड नो इज दैट इन द पाथोजेनेसिस द जेनेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी द मेन HLA involved is HLA-DR-B1 and also it is involved with the polymorphism in PTP and 22 gene. Just remember these two names, that's sufficient, okay? Because no need to go through the details in it because this should be taught in micro. The HLA-DR-B1 and that loci, all that MHC complexes should be taught in micro. So I'm not going in detail. For the genetic susceptibility, just remember HLA-DRB1 and polymorphism in PTP and 22 gene. Because this might be your MCQ question as well. The PTP and 22 associated with rheumatoid arthritis like that and HLA-DRB1. The main you have to remember is the HLA-DRB1. Okay. And the next one is environmental arthritogen, which involves the Epstein-Barr virus, retrovirus, parvovirus, mycobacteria, borrelia, proteus mirabilis, and mycoplasma. Similarly, for the autoimmunity, what it says that it is an autoimmune disorder. For this, both the CD4 helper T cell and the memory T cell plays the main role in this pathogenesis of rheumatoid arthritis. There is the recruitment of neutrophils and monocytes by the helper T cell, that is TH17, and the TH1 cells are produced by the interferon gamma. And what happened is that the main pathogenesis is because of the formation of autoantibodies, that is IgM mostly. This rheumatoid factor are the IgM1, okay, which are produced, which bind, this IgM bind to the Fc portion of IgG, and this and autoantibodies are the rheumatoid factor which forms the immune complexes and get deposit in the joint and other tissue leading to tissue damage. Is it clear?
Ma'am, once again.
What happened is that in this autoimmunity one, there is the destruction of the one immune system, okay? Autoimmunity means the one's own immune system is being involved. How? In this rheumatoid arthritis, formation of autoantibodies occur. What kind of autoantibodies? These autoantibodies are the IgM mostly, but less commonly IgG, that binds to the Fc portion of immunoglobulin G, which is known as rheumatoid factor. And this rheumatoid factor forms the immune complexes, which get deposited in the joint and other tissue, leading to inflammation and tissue damage. Your pathogenesis, just your autoimmunity, ko ye kura aile pachadi pani auncha, I'll be explaining later as well. Okay. What happened is that for a rheumatoid arthritis to occur in a genetically susceptible host, either by a arthritogenic antigen, that may be either bacteria or a self antigen, such as cyclic citrullinated peptide. This antigen is being activated by CD4 helper T cell. Okay. And this, what happened is that this CD4 helper T cell cause the breakdown of self tolerance, means the capacity to react with the other pathogen. Okay, that is being broken down. Immunological self tolerance means the activated lymphocytes or relay say or cheese or some interact with capacity say common. Okay, they were say you inflammatory reaction occur. बुझ्यो अटोइम्युन रियाक्सन भनेको आफ्नो बडीको ओन इम्युन सिस्टमसँग रियाक्ट गरेर यो साइटोकाइन्स एन्ड इन्फ्लामेटरी मेडिएटर्सहरू रिलिज हुन्छ होइन जसले गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ यो साइटोकाइन्स एज इन्टरल्युकिन 17-1-6 इन्टरफेरोन गामाहरूले चाहिँ यो साइनोविसाइट्सहरूलाई चाहिँ एक्टिभेट गर्छ र फर्दर यो साइटोकाइन्सहरू प्रड्युस गर्छ क्या यो नाइट्रिक अक्साइड टिएनएफ प्रोस्टाग्लान्डिन E2 इन्टरल्युकिन 26 जसले चाहिँ कार्टिलेजहरूको चाहिँ डिस्ट्रक्सन गर्छ क्या आर्टिकुलर सर्फेसलाई चाहिँ डिस्ट्रोय गर्छ एन्ड अल्सो ओस्टियोक्लास्टिक एक्टिभिटी इन द जोइन्ट इज इन्क्रिज्ड ओस्टियोक्लास्टिक एक्टिभिटी इन्क्रिज भएपछि देयर इज मोर बोन रिजर्प्सन र बोन इरोजन हुन्छ ओके अ ससेप्टिबल पर्सन ओके एक्सपोजर टु आइदर यहाँ अघि भन्यो नि होइन इन्भाइरोमेन्टल फ्याक्टर्स जस्तै एप्सटिन बार भाइरस रेट्रो भाइरस पार्वो भाइरससँग एक्सपोज भएको होस् या इन प्रेजेन्स अफ दिस एचएलए डिआर B1 इन सच एन इन्डिभिजुअल वाट हेपन्स इज द्याट दर इज द फेलियर अफ सेल्फ टोलरेन्स मिन्स देयर इज अनरेगुलेटेड लिम्फोसाइट एक्टिभेसन द लिम्फोसाइट्स proliferate okay and similarly there may be either environmental factors as infection smoking which may cause the enzymatic modification and this causes what this causes the production of helper T1 cell TH17 cells okay this TH1 and TH17 cell what they cause the proliferation of fibroblast chondrocytes synovial cells which cause the release of this collagenase stromilysin, elastase, prostaglandin E2 and this causes the further bone erosion, destruction, forming pannus, fibrosis and ankylosis. Dujo, is it clear?
Pannus maniko kyo ma'am?
Pannus maniko jem, it is produced by the proliferating synovium, okay? अलङ विथ ग्रान्युलेसन टिस्यु इन्फ्लामेटरी सेल्सहरूको कम्बिनेसन भएपछि एउटा नोड्युल जस्तो भन्छ के आई सो यु ओके दिस इज अ बोन ओके दिस इज कार्टिलेज एन्ड देयर इज अ फर्मेसन अफ इन बिट्विन दिस कार्टिलेज इन सर्फेस देयर इज अ फर्मेसन अफ अ नोड्युल दिस नोड्युल इज कम्पोज अफ प्रोलिफरेटिङ दिस नोड्युल इज फर्म बाई दि यो चाहिँ हाइपरप्लास्टिक साइनोभियम भयो होइन दिस हाइपरप्लास्टिक साइनोभियम अलङ विथ इन्फ्लामेटरी टिस्यु ग्रान्युलेसन टिस्युहरूको कम्बिनेसन भएर एउटा नोड्युल जस्तो भन्छ द्याट इज प्यानस डेफिनेसन प्रपर डेफिनेसन चाहिँ मैले यहाँ लेखिदिएको छु है लाइक इट इज प्रड्युस बाई प्रोलिफरेटिङ साइनोभियल सेल्स एडमिस विथ इन्फ्लामेटोरी सेल्स ग्रान्युलेसन टिस्यु फाइब्रस कनेक्टिभ टिस्यु द ओभरग्रोथ अफ दिस टिस्यु इज ट्रान्सफर्म इन्टु इडेमाटस फ्रन्ट लाइक प्रोजेक्सन भनेको यही प्यानस चाहिँ will result in formation of villi like structure okay yo finger like projection jasto dekhirachha ni that is due to this pannus along with aggregates of lymphocyte at the center microscopically cha esto dekhcha haina tara grossly cha bhanda kheri euta nodule jasto bane huncha ke bone ma is it clear
yes ma'am
ओके यही कुरालाई चाहिँ यहाँ यसरी बनाएको छ इफ you can't if you find difficulty explaining this picture you can write this way तर यो कुरा नै यही छ के जस्ट यहाँ फाइब्रोब्लास्ट कोलाजिन यो कोलाजिन स्ट्रोमिलाइसिन भनेर चाहिँ यता मेन्सन छैन होइन तर मेन थिङ भनेको चाहिँ त्यही कुनै पनि एउटा ससेप्टेबल होस्टमा अन एक्सपोजर टु एन एन्टिजेन देयर इज अ ब्रेकडाउन अफ सेल्फ टोलरेन्स रिजल्टिङ इन द रिलिज अफ इन्फ्लामेटरी मेडिएटर्स एन्ड साइटोकाइन्स स्टिमुलेट्स द साइनोविसाइट्स producing the inflammatory mediators and matrix metalloproteinase which causes the destruction of the articular cartilage and also there is an increase in the osteoclastic activity that contribute to bone destruction main theme bhaneko cha eti ho bujhyo
yes ma'am
is it clear to others
yes ma'am
तर यो इन्टरल्युकिन यो चाहिँ सम्झिनु पर्छ है कुन कुन इन्टरल्युकिन्स प्ले एन इम्पोर्टेन्ट रोल इन रुमेटोइड आर्थराइटिस द्याट इज इन्टरल्युकिन 17, 1, 6, 23 इन्टरफेरोन गामा टिएनएफ ट्रान्सफर्मिङ ग्रोथ फ्याक्टर बिटा यिनीहरू चाहिँ अलिकति याद चाहिँ हुनुपर्छ है मेन चाहिँ यो इन्टरल्युकिन 17 किन म्याक्रोफेजहरूले चाहिँ इन्टरल्युकिन 17 प्रड्युस गर्छ नि त अनि यसमा मेन रोलहरू नै म्याक्रोफेजी इन्फ्लामेटरी सेल्सहरूकै हुन्छ कि है इज इट क्लियर
ओके
ओके ओके नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड इज दैट जॉइंट मा चाहिँ के हुन्छ देयर इज द सिमेट्रिक आर्थराइटिस मींस इफ वन अफ द जॉइंट अफ वन ह्यान्ड इज इन्वॉल्वड देन द अदर जॉइंट अफ द अदर ह्यान्ड इज आल्सो बीइंग इन्वॉल्वड सिमेट्रिकल इन्वॉल्वमेंट अफेक्टिंग द स्मॉल जॉइंट अफ ह्यान्ड्स फीट एंकल नी रिस्ट एंड एल्बो and mostly the proximal interphalangeal and the metacarpophalangeal joint are affected but distal interphalangeal joint are spared proximal ra metacarpo proximal interphalangeal ra metacarpophalangeal joint are involved tara distal interphalangeal joint are spared this will distinguish it from osteoarthritis osteoarthritis ma chha distal interphalangeal joint chha mostly involved huncha hai and also the upper cervical spine will be involved in rheumatoid arthritis and morphologically what we see this is the chronic papillary synovitis with synovial cell hyperplasia and dense perivascular inflammatory cell infiltrate forming the lymphoid follicles vascularity is increased due to angiogenesis and also there is a presence of neutrophils and fibrin over the synovial surface increased osteoclastic activity causing the bone erosion pannus formation pannus bhaneko yo ma aile figure ma aile bhanne jai pannus bhaneko te agi dekhai halline haina that is pannus formation there is a destruction of articular cartilage along with fibrosis and ossification kasto huncha ta bhanda micros morphologically herda khari papillary synovitis huncha jastai What you have to say is that there is the hyperplasia of the synovium. Okay, you say synovocytes line gareko tissue. You know there is a hyperplasia of synovium with dense inflammatory infiltrates comprising mostly of plasma cell lymphocytes. On surface, ma say yeah, surface ma say even there may be neutrophils and fibrin ko organization huna sakcha over the surface, and these synovocytes may be organized into papillary infoldings okay giving a finger like projection hajur ke bhayo bujhenu hello hello bujhenu ke bhayo this is organized into papillary projection mm-hmm. हेलो बुझे ना वो
मेरा कुछ मैम
के इसमें से क्यों होता है अंधेरी यो जुन साइन अफ वी साइड्स हरु छन यो साइन अफ वी लाइनिंग को हाइपरप्लेजिया हुन्छ ओके एंड आल्सो देयर इज अ दिस प्रोलिफरेटिंग साइन अफ वी साइड्स विल बी अरेंज्ड इन अ फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शन माइक्रोस्कोपिकली विथ एग्रीगेट्स ऑफ लिम्फोसाइट्स और द लिम्फोइड फॉलिकल फॉर्मिंग अ लिम्फोइड फॉलिकल इन देयर स्ट्रोमा ओके विथ डेंस इन्फिल्ट्रेशन ऑफ लिम्फोसाइट्स प्लाज्मा सेल्स आल्सो एंड देयर मे बी द presence of neutrophilic debris and the fibrin deposition over the surface one ho ja ke bhayo is it clear now joint yes, mass okay joint mass what you have to know is that there is a sign involvement of the synovium with pannus formation erosion of articular cartilage fibrosis ossification can cause ankylosis okay similarly in skin what happens is that there is a formation of nodule that is subcutaneous nodule which mostly occur in the extensor surface of the forearm elbow occiput but can also be present in viscera as long spleen heart outer these are form non tender nodules these subcutaneous nodules are form and non tender round to oval with 2 cm in diameter when we look for this rheumatoid nodule even at Chowkot we have this slide of rheumatoid nodule how does it look like it looks like a zone of fibrinoid necrosis surrounded by epithelioid histiocytes with numerous lymphocytes and plasma cells look in this picture this is the area of fibrinoid necrosis okay with palisades histiocytes or epithelioid cells along with the infiltration of lymphocytes and plasma cells okay rheumatoid nodules say area of fibrinoid necrosis surrounded by rim of epithelioid histiocytes infiltrated by lymphocytes and plasma cells is to the hinds hai rheumatoid nodule is it clear
yes ma'am
okay and what happens is that in the blood vessels the medium and the small size arteries are involved the vasa nervorum and distal arteries resulting in end arteritis obliteris vasa nervorum means the वासा नर्वरम भनेको चाहिँ त्यस्तो स्मल वेसल्स आर्टरीजहरू हो जसले चाहिँ इन्टायर नर्भलाई चाहिँ ब्लड सप्लाई गरिरहेको हुन्छ होइन दे मे बी अल्सो अफेक्टेड ओके एन्ड इभन देन मे बी पेरिफेरल न्युरोप्याथी अल्सो ग्याङ्ग्रिन एन्ड ल्युकोसाइटिक ल्युकोसाइटोक्लास्टिक ग्रेन्युलाइटिस वाट डस दिस मिन इज द्याट द स्मल वेसल्स विल बी इन्भल्भ एन्ड देयर इज the fragmentation of the neutrophils and its debris can be seen leukocytoclastic venulitis bhaneko chai or the vasculitis bhaneko chai there is involvement of the small size vessels with fragmented neutrophils and its debris present okay so the patient may also have purpura cutaneous ulcers and the infarction of the nail bed others involve the serosus involvement that is pericarditis pruritus and even in the long parenchyma may undergo interstitial fibrosis and in eye there may be uveitis and keratoconjunctivitis these are all the extra articular manifestation you should remember okay involvement is the joint or the extra articular manifestation is in the blood vessels lung eye you have to mention in that way okay is it clear The clinical features involved mostly the four criteria out of these following criteria all these criteria are equally important but there must be at least the presence of the four criteria. There is morning stiffness means when a person wake up from his bed, he will feel that all his joints have become stuck or stiff, as difficult in moving his fingers and his limb. Okay, and arthritis of three or more joint areas. Arthritis of hand joint. There should be symmetrical arthritis. Should be the presence of rheumatoid nodule. And serum radial rheumatoid factor. Serum rheumatoid factor is increased. For the rheumatoid arthritis, we look for the rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP antibody. That is antibody against cyclic citrullinated peptide. But the most specific is anti-CCP antibody rather than rheumatoid factor. Okay? Because in every person, the rheumatoid factor may not be increased. Is it clear? You should remember this criteria, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and also the patient may present with malaise, fatigue, painless musculoskeletal pain, and also there is involvement of the small joints, symmetrical involvement of the small joints. The joints can be swollen, painful, stiff, or following inactivity or when the person wake up from the bed. And what we look in the radiographic finding is that we see the joint effusion, there is bone erosion, narrowing of the joint space, osteopenia, loss of articular cartilage with the destruction of tendon, ligament and joint capsule, radial deviation of the wrist and the ulnar deviation of the fingers. This means when we look on the x-ray, the ulnar deviation of fingers means the fingers are medially deviated. Okay. And also the flexion hyperextension abnormality means the swan neck deformity. It means that when you look at the finger, what happens is that regarding similar to that of this swan neck, there is the flexion of the distal interphalangeal joint and hyperextension of the proximal interphalangeal joint. Did you get that?
Very one, you know.
Swan neck deformity, Monica. Take your index finger and bend it. The distal part will be flexion of the distal interphalangeal joint and hyperextension of the proximal interphalangeal joint. Please go through internet and check the pictures. Okay, how does it look like? The swan neck to bottonnier deformity are just opposite to one another. Okay, ma'am. Radiographical means ki dekhta hai. Main you should know joint erosion, osteopenia, bony destruction, articular cartilage loss by down. So there is the narrowing of the joint space, even the ulnar deviation of the fingers. That means the finger will be medially deviated. Ulnar side tira one. Basically, the medially deviation of the fingers. So even radiographical even dekhta. And this swan neck and bottonnier deformity are just opposite of one another. Go through the internet and look at the picture. Okay, how does it look like? यसमा चाहिँ खासै देखाउनु खोजे होइन यसमा चाहिँ बोनी डिफर्मिटी जस्तै यो यतातिर डेभिएट भएको देखाएको छ होइन मेडियल डेभिएसन जस्तो देखाएको छ नि यो अल्नर डेभिएसन अफ फिङ्गरलाई चाहिँ यस्तो भनिन्छ कि अलिकति मेडियल्ली डेभिएट भएको छ नि ह्यान्ड त्यसलाई चाहिँ देखाउन खोजेको तर बोनी डिफर्मिटी हुन्छ भनेर भन्न खोजे मेन चाहिँ ओके Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You rheumatoid arthritis ma ke bujha chaina?
Ma'am, rheumatoid arthritis ma citrullination ko significance ke huncha, ma'am?
Citrullinated protein haru bhaneko chha yesto protein haru ho haina jun chai like yo huncha ni fibrin haru ma chai present huncha re ke tara yesma chai tes यसको यो साइट्रोलिनेटेड प्रोटिनमै मोडिफिकेसन भएर पनि चाहिँ यो रिम्याटोइड आर्थराइटिस हुन्छ अरे भनेर भन्ने चाहिँ छ. त्यस्तो डेफिनेट कुनै थ्योरी चाहिँ छैन.
म्याम यो त्यो फिङ्गर यस्तो डेभिएट हुने त त्यो गाउँमा हरेक बुढाबुढीको हुन्छ, सबैलाई रिउमेटोइड आर्थराइटिस भयो हुन्छ त्यस्तो?
होइन होइन, रिउमेटोइड आर्थराइटिस यु शुड हैव टू सी द फॉलोइंग क्राइटेरिया. एटलिस्ट मॉर्निंग स्टिफनेस तो ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिस में पनि त हुन सक्छ नि हैन. तर अघि मैले भने नि त ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिस में डिस्टल इंटरफेलिंजियल जॉइंट इज मोस्टली इन्वॉल्व. रिउमेटोइड आर्थराइटिस में हुँदैन. रिउमेटोइड आर्थराइटिस सम त ओल्ड एज में मात्र हुन्छ भन्ने छैन. ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिस विल बी मोस्टली आफ्टर द एज अफ 45-50 इयर्स पछि बल्ल ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिस हुन थाल्छ. एन्ड अनि ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिस र रिउमेटोइड आर्थराइटिस छुटाउनलाई यु शुड अल्सो डु दिस रिउमेटोइड फ्याक्टर एन्ड एन्टी सिसिपी एन्टिबडी. मोस्ट स्पेसिफिक इज एन्टी सिसिपी एन्टिबडी. इफ इट इज राइज देन डेफिनेटली इट्स रिउमेटोइड आर्थराइटिस एन्ड नट ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिस. एन्ड अलोङ विथ द्याट देयर शुड बी सिमेट्रिक आर्थराइटिस. ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिसमा सिमेट्रिक आर्थराइटिस हुन पनि सक्छ, नहुन पनि सक्छ. रिउमेटोइड नोड्युल्सहरू जुन पेनलेस नन टेन्डर यो सानो सबक्युटेनियस नोड्युल्सहरू सधैँ रिउमेटोइड आर्थराइटिसमा हुन्छ, नट इन उसमा के अरे ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिसमा. सो देयर आर डिफरेंट क्राइटेरिया. नट ओन्ली अन द बेसिस अफ रेडियोलॉजिकल फाइन्डिङ वी क्यान से दैट इट्स रिउमेटोइड और ओस्टियोआर्थराइटिस. ओके, इज इट क्लियर?
यस मैम.
मैम
हजुर,
यो हार्टमा कसरी प्रब्लम गर्छ? हार्टमा पनि प्रब्लम गर्छ भनेर लेखेछ त.
हार्टमा चाहिँ के हुन्छ त भन्दाखेरि यो इन्फ्लामेटरी साइटोकाइन्सहरूले चाहिँ होइन, यो म्याक्रोफेजेसहरूले चाहिँ यो एथेरोस्क्लेरोसिस गर्नको लागि चाहिँ प्रमोट गर्छ के, सो द्याट द इभन द पर्सन मे हेभ एमआई मायोकार्डियल इन्फार्क्सन भएर डेथ हुन सक्छ के.
ओके म्याम,
यो एथेरोस्क्लेरोटिक प्लागहरू फर्मेसनमा चाहिँ यो इन्फ्लामेटरी साइटोकाइन्सहरूले चाहिँ रोल प्ले गर्छ, जसले गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ द पर्सन मे इभन हेभ एमआई भन्न खोज्याउ के हार्टमा. इज इट क्लियर?
ओके म्याम, थ्याङ्क यू म्याम.
वेलकम. इज एनी अदर क्वेसन? Is there any other question? Hello?
No, ma'am.
Okay, next class we'll be studying gout and is it disease, okay? I think your class, next class will be on Friday. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, bye-bye. Have a good day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, welcome. Bye-bye. Mummy, mail ma padhai dinchu hai.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes?
Ma'am, you osteoporosis tha ni? अनि त्यो चाहिँ ओल्ड एजमा क्याल्सियमको कमी भयो भने हुन्छ भन्छ नि त. अनि त्यसमा चाहिँ फेरि ब्लडको क्याल्सियम लेभल नर्मल चाहिँ कसरी हुन्छ म्याम?
ओस्टियोपोरोसिस त मैले स्टार्टै गराएको छैन त.
ए होइन, त्यो अस्ति नै दिएको थियो अनि क्वेसन आएको थियो कि त्यही भएर.
केमा?
एनाटोमीमा देखाएको थियो म्याम.
त्यो ओस्टियोपोरोसिस च्याप्टरमा पढौँला नि.
हस् हस् हस्
है. एन्काइलोसिस भनेको थाहा भएन, अब्दुल रफले सोधेको हो. एन्काइलोसिस भनेको त्यही इमोबिलिटी अफ जोइन्ट हुने हो कि, स्टिफनिङ र इमोबिलिटी अफ द जोइन्ट है. यो चाहिँ म आदित्यको मेलमा पठाइदिन्छु एन्ड इन नेक्स्ट क्लास विल बी स्टडिङ गाउट एन्ड पेजेट डिजिज ओके
हस म्याम थैंक यू
बाय
बाय म्याम
बाय बाय